Okay. Welcome. Joe, that's right. There's Joe Temperley. Don't stop, that makes him feel good. This next gentleman I have the honor of hosting, I met him when he was 14 in Philadelphia. Then I was maybe 26, 25. He was playing the piano, and he was playing one of the most complex tunes that I'd written to that point. And I was wondering, how does a kid that's 14 in Philly know this tune? And I thought he was a piano player. Then they said, this guy plays bass. He came down to the Academy of Music in Philly, was the hall that we played in then. And I said, what you want to play, man? And I thought he would name some conservatives. He said, man, let's play J. Mood. That was some wild blues that I had written. I said, how do you know that? He said, I know this music. And then when he started playing, he blew all of our minds. The great Marcus Roberts was playing piano with me at that time. He said, man, what about this kid? There's hope for this music. Then he sat down and played about 15 Monk tunes on the piano. He went to the High School of Creative and Performing Arts in Philadelphia. Kurt Rosenwinkel went there. Questlove went there. Joey DeFrancesco, and also the members of the R&B group Boys to Men. So they had a lot of music going on. He's been the artistic director of the Jazz Aspen Snowmass Summer Sessions and the co-director of the National Jazz Museum in Harlem and the creative chair for jazz of the Los Angeles Philharmonic Association. And currently, he is the artistic advisor for the jazz program at New Jersey PAC. So you see, when people get a little bit of him, they want a lot of him. His first big band recording, The Good Feeling, won the 2012 Grammy for Best Large Jazz Ensemble Album. Give him something. And that album was recorded after they spent a week in our club, Dizzy's Club Coca-Cola. When he was a sophomore in high school, I conducted a high school band with him, and Walter Blanding was in the band. And Walter could play then. I just want to say he was just as lovable and supremely talented and spirited, and he has remained that way. Irrepressible in the infectious good feeling that he brings to every occasion. He embodies it and his playing represents it. In 1995, we commissioned him to write a chart for the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra. That's 95 I'm talking about. This was the beginning of his career as a big band composer and arranger. There's none finer. With deep love, I'd like to bring on Mr. Christian McBride. Christian McBride. Christian McBride. Walter Blanding. Vincent Gardner. Marcus Printup. That was entitled Bluesin' in Alphabet City. Now we're gonna slow things down and get to the bowl. That's always a very wistful time when the bowl comes out. And this is entitled In the Wee Small Hours of the Morning. That's the time you have to spend with that bowl in hand. Christian maybe wants to add something about this. Walter Blanding, Christian McBride, also wonderful arrangement, Christian McBride. Now, normally the host has to scrounge up arrangements or do them, call all the cats and say, what you think about this? But in this case, Christian has done all of the arrangements, so all I have to do is talk and play parts. And it's easy to talk about him because he is fantastic, and he always was. So I want to stress that. When I met him as a young man, he was absolute. This next piece is a crowd favorite tune from his 2009 Mac Avenue release, Kind of Brown. You should give him something for that title. That's a good title. The recording is by his band Inside Straight, a quintet featuring Carl Allen, Eric Reed, Warren Wolf, and Steve Wilson. This is entitled Used to Could. Thank you.
Chris Crenshaw, Sherman Irby, composer and arranger Christian McBride,
this is entitled I Thought About You. And this is an arrangement that Christian originally did for a concert at Jazz Aspen Snowmass, where he was the artistic director for Terrence Blanchard, my homeboy and classmate, and also a fine composer and arranger. We hope you enjoy this. I Thought About You.
Thank you.
This next tune is featured on Christian's second album as a leader, titled Number 2 Express. He's been documented on over 300 recordings, including 16 as a leader or co-leader. Hi. That's why we built it close like this, so we can wave at people. We like that. This song is entitled Youthful Bliss. Now, for many years, he was always the youngest or one of the youngest people in all the bands in which he ever performed. Many of us up here have experienced this, but he really experienced it because he was a professional at 14. His new trio is the first group in which he has performed that he is the elder statesman. Now, he's not messing around in Joe's territory, but Joe just looks at you and you be quiet, you know? A part of his, a sign of his age and wisdom is that he's not listening to what I'm saying. Let's see. It comes with age, you know? Christian's trio has the phenomenal Christian Sands, who's only 24, and yes. Ulysses Owens Jr. is 31. But Christian now is passing on the tradition of music with all those good stories. He has a lot of great stories, and that's a part of our music. Music is really a communal experience. Many of us up here on the bandstand, we've known each other for a very long time, and it's an aspect of our music that we love. So we hope you enjoy this piece. It's a titled Youthful Bliss.
Christian McBride.
Now we'd like to conclude with a piece that Christian has arranged for the great trumpeter Freddie Hubbard. And when he first met Freddie, he played all of Freddie's tunes for him on the piano. And then after Freddie was duly impressed, he said, "But I'm really a bass player." And Freddie said, "I'm looking for a bass player." You never forget the musician that brings you on the road and gives you a chance to play. The older musician gives you a chance for that experience. Without that, it's virtually impossible to learn how to play. For me, it was the great Art Blakey. And Freddie Hubbard had and Freddie also had the opportunity to play with Art Blakey 20-something years earlier. And I know Christian feels the same type of love and affinity for Freddie. He worked with him from 1990 to 93. This is an impossible to play tune that Freddie wrote when he was playing with the Jazz Messengers with Art Blakey. It's entitled Thermo. And Christian is going to conclude giving us a workout. We hope that you have enjoyed the music, and we know you're going to enjoy this one. Freddie Hubbard's Thermo, Christian McBride arrangement.
McBride. Christian McBride. Vicky Lawrence. Kenny Renton. Christian McBride. We have the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra. Thank you very, very much for coming out tonight. We hope you've had an enjoyable evening. It's certainly been our pleasure. For Kirk Rosenwinkel and Christian McBride, two sons of Philadelphia, it's been a pleasure performing for you. Christian McBride on the bass and arrangements. Take care and have a good night.